robed in white, and where have they come from? I said to him, Sir, you are the one that knows. Then he said to me, These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. tall ceilings and clear glass windows that show off both Georgia pines and Georgia's sun as it shines. Modern, simple, clean, a magnificent place to worship the Lord in the splendor of holiness. Really, really love this space. But I can't help but miss just a little bit the old church that once stood there. The old church was not as beautiful. A mission church built on what I imagine was a much tighter budget. The original church building was practical, very plain, sheetrock and cinder block. Except for the back of the church wall, where in the early 80s, a local artist painted a mural. Now, in the interest of full disclosure, I should add that while I have for many years loved the work of this artist, I've grown even more fond of her and her work in recent years because 5 years ago, she became my stepmother. That's another story. I really did like the mural before that. Anyhow, the mural is made up of famous saints throughout Christian history, including, of course, their patron saint, St. Gregory the Great, who in this 1980s rendition bears the face of John Gramrose, the man I've known most of my life. I grew up playing with his kids on Sunday afternoons. There's St. Martha, who's known as for service and domestic virtue, the patron saint for housewives and cooks, who legend tells us was en route from Palestine to France when she met a dragon and overcame it by spilling holy water on it. On the mural, St. Martha bears the face of the artist's mother. There are 9 saints in all on that mural at St. Gregory's Church in Athens, Georgia. St. Cecilia, who they put on there because they wanted to recall always their love of music. The Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Ambrose, St. Augustine, and St. Jerome, the patron saint of librarians, holding a book in his hand. I thought you liked that name too. holding a book in his hand. My favorite of all the saints on the mural because it was my father who posed in the stead of St. Jerome. And I love the image of my father as a saint. He will be the first to laugh at this notion and tell you he's much more comfortable in the role of a sinner. But there he is on the wall. Of course, part of why I love this mural is because I have family and history associated with it. But it goes beyond that. There is something powerful about imaging and imagining the saints, most of them so removed from our everyday thinking, yet so important in handing down this faith tradition to us. Who we are as a church, as the body of Christ, has been handed to us one generation to another, one person to another, a story, a song, a history, a witness, faces and hands, visions, strange and wonderful, passionate and brutal, weak and strong. The saints of God stand before us, icons of what it means to carry on this faith that has been making its way through the world for 2,000 years or so. And as that story is passed on to us, to those who will come after us, we begin to bear the marks of the stories of this curious church. We become part of that mural of stories, belonging to it every bit as much as our forebearers did. And so it is that on All Saints Day, or All Saints Sunday, we remember not only the great saints of the church, but also the teachings that founded this church. We meet Jesus on the Mount, the famous Sermon on the Mount, preaching as he speaks to the disciples and the crowds, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed, blessed, blessed." Jesus sits down on the hillside and hands out blessings. Here is what it means to be blessed. The challenge with Beatitudes is that we tend to hear them as prescriptive instead of descriptive. Want to know if you're on Jesus' blessed list? Well, here's the litmus test. Are you poor in spirit? be the ones who create the world that reflects the graciousness and goodness of God. And I don't know about you, but for me, that is both a burden and a joy to carry. To be what this beautiful and broken world so desperately needs. Burden or joy, here we are, all of us, each of us bringing blessing to this place, to this community, to this neighborhood, to this world. And we remember the saints of the church because they modeled that blessing so bravely and so boldly. They lived that blessing so much that at times it led them to march right up to their death. Often it led them to march right up into their life, being blessed, being blessed. And so today we sing the songs of the saints of God and we remember them. We remember our own saints as well, the saints and souls that have formed us, that have shaped us, that have helped fashion us into the people that we are, the people we are becoming. We who walk this road, we who dare to journey with the crucified, dead, and risen Christ, we who remember the saints of the church and the saints of our lives who have gone before us, we begin to take the shape of blessedness. We are blessed and we are blessing, just as the saints were. And as we look, we find ourselves etched more and more on that mural that is the kingdom of God. Our faces more and more like the saints who paved the way and the saints who pave it still. Thank you.
pray for our own needs and those of others, praying especially for Victory, Don, Nathan, Bruce, Don and Joanna, Duet, Joe, Robert, Sutherland and family, Conway and Eleanor, Jennifer, Sina, Carolyn, Beth, Valerie, Terry, Margaret and Rob, Helen, Nancy, Lloyd, Lynn, Leela, David, and for those we now name either silently or aloud. We offer thanksgiving for all who will receive the sacrament of baptism or confirmation on All Saints, and especially for Emily Kate and her parents as they prepare for Emily's baptism, for the birth of Jack, William and Kosky, son of Jackie and John, for Jennifer, Linda, and those celebrating birthdays, for Tyler and Anthony, nominees for ordination, sponsored by this parish.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us the forgiveness of sins, keep us in eternal life by his grace. Looks like they have some sense of where that could be pointed in our direction. If you feel called to this table, filled with wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help, so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, to the sorrowful, joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
And now as our Savior Christ has called us, we are born. body of Christ, bread.
Body of Christ, bread.
haste to do kindness. Shower blessing on friend and stranger alike, and make no peace with oppression. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, and remain with you.